हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द अनदर वीडियो ऑफ स्टार्टअप एंड रिकमिशनिंग ऑफ कोका रोबोट। लेट्स कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम द जॉगिंग द रोबोट विदाउट अ हायर लेवल सेफ्टी कंट्रोलर। डिस्क्रिप्शन: टू जॉग द रोबोट विदाउट अ हायर लेवल सेफ्टी कंट्रोलर, स्टार्टअप मोड मस्ट फर्स्ट बी एक्टिवेटेड। द रोबोट कैन देन बी जॉग्ड इन T1 मोड इफ सेफ ऑपरेशन इज यूज्ड। द रोबोट कैन ऑल्सो बी जॉग्ड इन CRR इफ द रोबोट टीम ऑप्शन इज यूज्ड। It is only possible to activate startup mode and jog the robot using the local smart pad. Danger: External safeguards are disabled in startup mode. Observe the safety instructions related to startup mode. The robot controller automatically deactivates startup mode in the following cases: if no operator action has been carried out within 30 minutes of activation, if the smart pad is switched to passive mode or disconnected from the robot controller, if the profile safe interface is used when a connection to a higher level safety controller is established, if the X11 interface is used when some input signals no longer have the state's logic 0. In startup mode, the system switches to the following simulated input image: the external emergency stop is not active, the safety gate is open, no safety stop 1 has been requested, no safety stop 2 has been requested, no safe operational stop has been requested, only for VKR C4 E2 is closed if safe operation or safe range monitoring is used. Startup mode also influences other signals. Information about the effects of startup mode in conjunction with safe operation or safe range monitoring can be found in the documentation Safe Operation and Safe Range Monitoring. Precondition: if the profile safe interface is used, no connection to a higher level safety controller. If the X11 interface is used, all input signals have the state logic 0, operating mode T1 or CRR. In the case of VKR C4, no E2/E7 signals activated via a USB stick or retrofit interface. In the case of robot team, the local smart pad is used. Procedure: in the main menu, select Startup, Service, Startup Mode. Startup mode is active. Touching the menu item deactivates the mode. Startup mode is not active. Touching the menu item activates the mode. Next is checking the activation of the positionally accurate robot model. Description: if a positionally accurate robot is used, it must be checked that the positionally accurate robot model is activated. In the case of positionally accurate robots, position deviation resulting from workpiece tolerances and elastic effects of the individual robots are compensated for. The positionally accurate robot positions the programmed TCP anywhere in the Cartesian workspace within the tolerance limits. The model parameters of the positionally accurate robot are determined at the calibration station and permanently saved on the robot RDC. The positionally accurate robot is only valid for the robot as delivered following conversion or retrofitting of the robot, example with an arm extension or a new wrist. The robot must be recalibrated. Functions: a positionally accurate robot has the following functions: increased positioning accuracy approximately by the factor 10, increased path accuracy. A precondition for the increased positioning and path accuracy is the correct input of the load data into the robot controller. Simplified transfer of programs if the robot is exchanged, no reteaching. Simplified transfer of programs after offline programming with work visual, no reteaching. Procedure: in the main menu, select Help, Info. Check the robot tab that the positionally accurate robot model is activated. That's it for today's video. In the next video, we'll continue from activating palletizing mode.